वेलकम टू शरत चंद्र आईलेट क्लैट HSEE यूट्यूब चैनल. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड डिटेल एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ आईलेट 2021 पेपर जीके सेक्शन. देन वी विल ऑल्सो लर्न सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टिप्स एंड अप्रोच फॉर द 2022 आईलेट पेपर. Question number 1. Who was top seeded in 53 kg category in wrestling for the Tokyo Olympic 2021? Here it is a direct question. A. Vinesh Phogat is the answer. 37. That is question number 2 in GK section. Joe Biden is the president of United States of America. If you see, 45th president is Donald Trump, and 46th one is Joe Biden. 38. Which country sent 9 satellites into space from the first sea-based commercial launches? This is China, and these 9 satellites sent by using Long March 11, and by using this they sent 9 satellites. And it is in news because they sent it from sea-based commercial launch from the bank of Yellow Sea. So if you are identifying any launches, so from this year onwards, you should also focus on, that is, the location and relevant geographical features too. Question number 39. One among the major economies or country to phase out both coal-based and atomic energy-based power generation is. This year, actually, carbon neutral, a concept which was in news from last few months. However, IELTS paper tested aspirant knowledge on which country's announcement regarding phasing out of coal and atomic energy. It is Germany which announced this in last year. So one has to maintain major announcements regarding environment protection from different countries. So if any country announcing like they are going to remove coal based thermal power plants or atomic energy power plants, so one has to maintain specific attention towards such kind of announcements. That is what we can give you a tip for the next year preparation. Which of the following recently released closest ever breathtaking picture of the sun? So here NASA is the answer. So those who are following NASA recent updates, but this year we expected question from NASA Mars mission, that is Perseverance, or Chinese mission Tianwen. However, this year in a wake of surprise, they gave the question which is less famous in the current affairs. Question number 41. The government of India decided to celebrate the birth anniversary of which freedom fighter as Parakram Divas or Day of Valour? So see, this is the first ever Parakram Divas, and we expected this question also. So Subhash Chandra Bose is a founder who revived INA. So this was a direct question. Which of the following bodies is neither a constitutional body nor a statutory body? So constitutional body, by the name itself, you can understand that it is established by the constitution, whereas statutory body is established by a law or an act. So now if you see, National Disaster Management Authority established by National Disaster Management Act 2003, so 2005, whereas National Anti-Profiteering Authority established by GST, and then Central Consumer Protection Authority established by Consumer Protection Act 2018. Consumer Protection Act 2019. Okay, so if you see, if you eliminate all these options, so Law Commission of India is neither constitutional nor statutory body. Okay, so option A is the answer in this case. In September 2020, the Parliament of India passed three farm bills. Farm produce, trade and commerce, which allows farmer to trade and to sell out of the APMCs. Then Essential Commodities Act, which allows government to delist some commodities in Essential Commodities Act, and Farmers Act, which allows contract farming. So now if you see, the question is, which of the following is not dealt with this law? So whoever preparing for IELTS exam or a HSE exam, so we recommended them to follow Farm Acts and the ambitions of the three acts. So now the first act is, that is Farm Produce, Trade and Commerce Promotion Facilitation Act, promotes the sale of produce outside the APMCs. Then contract farming is also mentioned here, and then removal of income tax is not mentioned in any farm act. Restrictions of situations in which supply of foodstuff can be regulated. So this is in the Essential Commodities Act. So the answer is C in this case. So next question, which internet giant committed to investigate 10 billion over the next 5 to 7 years towards digitizing Indian economy as part of India Digitization Fund. So it is Google. Let us say, if you are not aware about this issue, however, if you see, Google initiated this in last year, and it was in news because it want to promote local languages also. So because of that reason, it became a little bit a buzz topic in that month. Then Government of India recently signed a pact for $500 million project to build safe and green national highway corridor in Rajasthan, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh. Which are the following of these organizations? So now this is a typical question, because we may not remember such value, at the same time funds also. However, national highway corridors are building safe and green national highway corridors, giving a kind of guess. If you see, let us try elimination method. IMF will help the countries only in times of BOP crisis, that is balance of payment crisis. So what is balance of payment crisis? You can watch our previous current affairs videos. In that we explained what is balance of payment crisis in the CLAT current affairs videos. Then ADB will also give funds for the development activities, and G20 will give is just like a solution body, or a body which they will discuss about the economic issues. And then we left with the ADB and World Bank. So student who knows that World Bank will investigate most of the investing in most of the new projects, so they can go for it. However, ADB can be chosen, but World Bank is investing in such kind of projects. So if you read newspaper, you will aware about these issues. Well, you may not remember exactly, but you can aware by reading some newspapers every day. 46. This is a new type of question, because we recommend students to read recent Nobel Prize awards winners and their work. For example, this year, that is Paul Milgram and Robert Wilson. These people got economics Nobel Prize award. However, we recommended to read their theory, that is auction theory. Okay. However, they asked about their university. Okay, which is also a new type of questioning in the IELTS exam. So one has to maintain some comprehensive knowledge regarding these prizes in the next year. Question number 47. The present chairperson of National Human Rights Commission. If you see, in the month of December, National Human Rights Commission position remained vacant, because at that time, chairperson H.L. Dattu completed his tenure. Later, it was vacant. Recently, that is the month of July, in the end of the July, or I think June, Arun Kumar Misra, he replaced H.L. Dattu. So he is the person. So if you want more information regarding this, you can refer our previous July part 1 current affairs, where you will understand whole aspects of National Human Rights Commission. You will also understand what is the role of this body, who will appoint this, Human Rights Commission chairperson, because it's the president who will appoint him. And the remaining issues we discussed in that video. Next, question number 48. National Voters Day. So, very easy question. And it is 25th January. 25th January. So, option B is a right answer. Next question. Which of the following cannot cast their votes remotely through the postal ballot system in India? So, option A. Let us say this question, we don't know anything. So, option A, you can easily guess. That is, armed forces will vote through postal ballot. Then, government employees posted outside India, they can also use this method. Because all these diplomats who are working as ambassadors, they will mostly use this method. Then, remaining these two, we may not sure about the right answer. However, as per the Representation Act 1951, Rule 18, it mentioned that these voters can also, that is preventive detention people, can also vote under postal ballot. So, the remaining option is option C. So, these people cannot cast their vote through postal ballot system. Question number 50. Which of the following recently became the first state, first to successfully provide 100% functional household tap connections in rural areas? Direct question, it is Goa. Goa is in news. So, this question is, a direct question is Goa. 51. On 29th July 2020, Ministry of HRD, which is now Ministry of Education, unveiled National Education Policy. So, this is one of the expected question here. So, National Education Policy framed based on the recommendation of Kasturi Rangan Committee, who is ex-ISRO chairman. It is generally advised to students to read major features of this NEP, National Education Policy. So, the question asked about which of the following is not a feature of National Education Policy. So, option A is correct. Option B is also correct. And option C is not at all mentioned in NEP. Okay. So, C is the answer. Next. Where is the headquarters of the International Solar Alliance with over 120 members situated? So the answer is direct question on Paris 2015 deal, in which we saw the proposal to establish International Solar Alliance. The headquarters is Gurugram. Okay. Next, question number 53. By scoring half centuries in each of the innings in her test debut against England at Bristol in June 2021, which Indian cricketer became youngest woman to achieve this feat? Okay, so if you are following sports with some passion, or if you are following some current affairs also, you can easily, that is Sneha Rana is a person. Okay, then in the history of tennis in open era, and this is a direct question, so that is Roger Federer. One can easily guess the name. Almost 17 Grand Slams on his name. Question number 55. What is Belt and Road Initiative? This was in news from last few years. So, we expect students to read this issue in a briefed manner. If you see the first current affairs videos of Sarachandra CLAT Academy, or you can see in the CLAT Academy YouTube channel also, Sarachandra CLAT Academy YouTube channel also, where you will find explanation for this question. Here, option A is not correct. Option B is also not correct. Option C is the right answer. Because Belt and Road Initiative launched in 2013 by China to build infrastructure projects connecting Asia, Africa, and even Europe. Next question. According to Public Affairs Index. So now this is interesting, because we ask our students to focus more on index or famous reports. Index or famous reports. But this time they asked about some infamous one. However, we should not say infamous, because this Public Affairs Index was published by Public Affairs Center, which is headed by Kasturi Rangan. Okay, which is headed by Kasturi Rangan, former ISRO
former ISRO chairperson. So now, which of the following is correct? You see, they announced results in three categories: largest state, smaller state, and some other category. So in largest state category, it is Kerala and Tamil Nadu can be seen. In smaller state category, Goa is the only option which you can find in these above options. So it is B is the answer, which is considered to be answer, because even Kerala and Goa is also right. However, Kerala and Tamil Nadu placed in largest states. So by assuming that they both are in same area or same sector, the same domain, so we can call it as B is the answer. So B is the answer. We can say it B is the answer. Next, 57. Which of the following is fastest growing tech hub? So that is Bangalore. Okay, that is IT city of IT capital of India. Bangalore is the correct answer.
India was elected a member of UN Commission on Status of Women during September 2020 defeating. So actually Afghanistan and China and India was in competition, and India defeated China because at the last age India and China went to the tight competition, and China was defeated by India. Next question: India signed an agreement on 15-7-2020 to expand cooperation in cyber security. So this is completely one of the toughest question, because it is very difficult to remember the dates and cyber security also, because India agreed to have different cyber security agreements with different countries, but it is very difficult to remember. So but the answer is Israel, because at that time we have engagements with Israeli diplomats at the time. Question number 60, the quadrilateral security. So this is one of the most expected question, because Quad meeting happened recently, I mean in the last year, in the 2021 initial months. So one has to know what is Quad and everything. So USA, Japan, Australia and India. So just refer our previous CLAT current affairs videos, you will get more clarity about Quad. Next question: who was appointed as election commissioner? Because see, there are two names which are confusing here, because Sunil Chandra is right now our chief election commissioner, so people may go for this, but Anoop Chandra Pandey is the person appointed as the election commissioner. So one has to maintain clarity here, because it was asked about election commissioner, not chief election commissioner. Okay, this is the answer. India's foreign exchange reserves. So again, this is a new model question, because IELTS exam, yes, they will ask some statistics, but this time they asked it about foreign exchange in June 2021. So we believe that last 6 months, and students will leave last month current affairs like June, July. But this time they asked even about June also. So student has to maintain perfect focus before the exam month, even before the exam month also. Okay, so this is 600 billions. So that is US dollars 612 billions is the exact amount. Then next question: who is newly elected president? Expected question. So he is from Maldives external affairs, I mean finance, foreign minister, that is Abdullah Shahid is the answer. Abdullah Shahid is the answer. So option C is the correct answer in this case. Okay, option C is the correct answer in this case. Next, the US vice president have to use the casting vote to get the Senate's confirmation for the appointment of. So remember this, in India also, whenever votes are equal, at that time you will see voting of deputy, speaker. So here also what happened in USA, also same thing happened. This time USA vice president voted. So she voted for Kiran Ahuja. Okay, so Kiran Ahuja, and that is the answer, and she is the American attorney, and just remember this name, Kiran Ahuja. Okay, option B. Next question: who is the most philanthropic person in the world in the past 100 years. So this is again interesting one, because we will focus on most important reports. We will focus on most important reports, or else we will go for most important organizations and their reports. But this time they asked about some infamous one, because it is Edil Giv, an NGO, in a report mentioned that Jamshedji Tata is the most philanthropic person in the last 100 years. But we may remember this person name, that's the reason they asked. But however, we have to focus on some unimportant reports, but if they are explaining about a significant person or important person, we have to remember that report too. Question number 66. What is the diplomat mission between two Commonwealth nations? Remember, if it is a diplomatic mission between two Commonwealth, it is called as High Commission. If it is two non-Commonwealth, it is embassy. Okay, so the answer here is C. The answer here is C is the correct answer. Joint session of the parliament is presided over by. So it is very common question. Article 108 mentioned that joint session will be headed by speaker. In absence of speaker, it is deputy speaker of Lok Sabha. In absence of deputy speaker also, it is going to be deputy chairperson of Rajya Sabha. And in addition to this, we can remember that joint session, we brought it from Australian constitution. Cyclone Tauktae was recently in news. So what we expected is, they will ask which country named this. So the country which named it is Myanmar, and from that you can easily answer that it is Burmese language. Next, on 16th 2021, a team of 10 climbers from Nepal made history. So that is a direct question, that is option A is the answer. Next, what is the name of 2020 Tokyo Olympics mascot? So direct question, that is Mirai Tawa. Okay, so with this we concluded explanation of GK. I hope you got good score. So please keep on focusing on the next year preparation, those who are preparing for next year. All the very best. Thank you and Jai Hind.